Hi viewers, welcome to Spark and Crack IAS. Hi viewers, in this video we are going to see about the most expected 1000 prelims MCQs part 2 from 11 to 20 questions. Question number 11. The parliamentary supremacy may be defined by which of the following statements? Option A. Parliaments can make laws concerning any subject. Option B. A valid act of parliament cannot be questioned by the court. Option C. No parliament can bind a future parliament. Option D. All of the above. The right answer is option D. All of the above. Parliament can make laws concerning anything. No parliament can bind a future parliament. That is, it cannot pass a law that cannot be changed or reversed by a future parliament. A valid act of parliament cannot be questioned by the court. Parliament is the supreme lawmaker. Question number 12. Functionality of doctrine of Leibs policy came to an end with which of the following documents? Options are Option A. Queen's Proclamation 1858. Option B. Indian Council Act 1861. Option C. Lord Ripon's Resolution. Option D. Indian Council Act 1892. The right answer is Option A. Queen's Proclamation 1858. Doctrine of Leibs, most commonly associated with Lord Dalhousie. It was a major tool used for annexing the princely states without a legal heir. It led to the revolt of 1857. Queen's Proclamation 1858 announced after the end of the revolt and assured princely states that there wouldn't be any annexations further and ended a doctrine of Leibs. Question number 13. Which of the following is most appropriate about socialism in India? Options are Option A. State ownership of all industries. Option B. State's major role in economy. Option C. Equal distribution of wealth. Option D. Abolition of private property. The right answer is Option B. State's major role in economy. The word socialism had been used in the context of economic planning. It signifies major role in economy. State ownership and the abolition of private property are features of state socialism. India follows democratic socialism. Question number 14. Which of the following is or the causes of British success in India? Number 1. Superior army equipped with advanced weapons. Number 2. Able and ambitious leadership. Number 3. Excellent financial conditions. The options are Option A. 1 and 2. Option B. 2 and 3. Option C. 1 and 3. Option D. 1, 2 and 3. The right answer is Option D. 1, 2 and 3. Strong and disciplined army equipped with advanced weapons. Brilliant leadership in expansion and consolidation of British Empire. Company had a strong financial backup. Question number 15. Which of the following statements describes the meaning of constitutionalism? Number 1. It refers to the authority exercised by the state in the interest of citizens. Number 2. It refers to the limitation subject to which the authority should be exercised. Options are Option A. 1 only. Option B. 2 only. Option C. Both 1 and 2. Option D. Neither 1 nor 2. The right answer is Option C. Both 1 and 2. The term constitutionalism refers to the authority of the state. It also refers to the limitations subject to which the authority should be exercised. Principles of constitutionalism refers to two elements covering at one and the same time the extent of the power of a public authority and the limitations on that authority. Question number 16. Which of the following demands were primarily made by the moderate leaders? Number 1. Abolition of the Indian Council. Number 2. Complete independence. Number 3. Repeal of the Arms Act. Number 4. Introduction of permanent settlement to the other parts of India. Options are Option A. 1, 3 and 4. Option B. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Option C. 3 and 4. Option D. 1 and 3. The right answer is option A, 1, 3 and 4. The Congress during the first phase, 1865 to 1905, was the very modest. This phase was dominated by moderate leaders, so it is also called as moderate phase. Congress demanded moderate constitutional reforms, economic relief, administrative reorganization, and defense of civil rights. Leader of this phase didn't demand actively self-government and complete independence. Question number 17. Preamble is considered to be the key of the constitution because number 1. It provides the structure of the governance. Number 2. It explains the ideals to be achieved in India. Options are option A, 1 only. Option B, 2 only. Option C, both 1 and 2. Option D, neither 1 nor 2. The right answer is option C, both 1 and 2. The preamble briefly explains the objectives of the constitution in two ways. First, about the structure of the government in terms sovereign, socialism, secularism, democratic and republic. Second, about the deals to be achieved in independent India in terms justice, liberty, equality and fraternity. Question number 18. Consider the following statements about Hunter Commission, 1882. Number 1. It was asked to review the existing law and order structure in the country. Number 2. It was formed during the period of Lord Lytton. Options are option A, both 1 and 2. Option B, 2 only. Option C, 1 only. Option D, neither 1 nor 2. The right answer is option D, neither 1 nor 2. A commission was set up in 1882 under W.W. Hunter to review the progress made in the field of education following Wood's dispatch. It was formed during the period of Lord Ripon. It laid special emphasis on primary education, whose control ought to be transferred to district and municipal boards. Question number 19. Which of the following changes was or were brought by Lord Dalhousie? Number 1. Introduction of Labour's policy. Number 2. Appointment of Fraser Commission. Number 3. Establishment of Public Works Department. Options are option A, 1, 2 and 3. Option B, 1 and 2. Option C, 2 and 3. Option D, 1 and 3. The correct answer is option D, 1 and 3. Lord Dalhousie was the Governor General of India during 1848 to 1856. He introduced the doctrine of Labour's. He published a railway minute and laid down the first railway line connection Bombay and Thane, 1853. Telegraph and postal were introduced by him. Wood's dispatch published in 1854. Widow Remarriage Act 1856 came into effect. Public Works Department was established. Canals were opened in Ganga River. Question number 20. In the context of modern India, famous Port Hanover is associated with option A, Maratha Kingdom, option B, Mysore Kingdom, option C, Kakatiya Kingdom, option D, Gajapati Rulers. The right answer is option B, Mysore Kingdom. Kakatiya of Warangal region and Gajapati of Odisha region are associated with medieval India. So option C and D can be eliminated. Mysore ruler Hyder Ali took keen interest in sea trade. So he persuaded the merchants of different communities to come and settle in the ports of Mangalore, Hanover, Karwar and Calicut. He built a naval arsenal and a dockyard at Mangalore and Hanover for the construction of powerful navy. Hi viewers, thank you for watching my video. If you like my video, kindly like, comment, share and subscribe please.